Froedtert canceled all non-emergency surgeries last week after learning a patient may have Creutzfeldt-Jakob disease and could be exposing other patients. 12 News' Kent Wainscott is live from Froedtert Hospital tonight. And Kent, obviously this is good news for patients as well as the hospital.
Oh yeah, Toy, a big sigh of relief here at Froedtert tonight, and that's because the fear over a potential case of Creutzfeldt-Jakob disease, a rare and deadly brain disorder, has turned out to be a false alarm. The scare all began last Thursday when the hospital canceled all surgeries after a test on one of the surgical patients here proved inconclusive, opening up the possibility of the disease. About 100 other patients who had had surgery following that patient were notified of the potential health risk. It was all really a precaution at the time, but this afternoon the hospital put everyone's mind at ease with the long-awaited test results.
So I'm here to announce that the test that was performed on the patient that had surgery on Monday has returned and the test is negative. We informed patients that were operated on Tuesday and Wednesday of the remote possibility that this may be an issue, and we're clearly in the process of recontacting those patients to tell them that that precautionary move is now no longer concerning to them since the patient does not have Creutzfeldt-Jakob disease.
Now, that original test, the inconclusive test that started this whole scare, was actually done by another hospital. Froedtert's not identifying which hospital that was, but it was before the patient was transferred here. Froedtert was not notified of that test before the surgery took place, and hospital officials were actually caught by surprise by that test, and it led to the extensive and rather costly response. But everyone here this evening quite relieved that the test turned out to be negative. Reporting live from Froedtert, I'm Kent Wainscott.
And Kent, before you go, any update on the patient?
The patient was identified as a woman in her 70s, and we're told only that she has been released from the hospital. She is recovering at home and doing fine.
All right, Kent. Thank you.